Shake Table Lab by Gracie O'Connell and Sophie Hartman. The first thing I had to do was draw a sketch of my building. I made approximate measurements of the width and length of the building. We decided to have the width of our building 20 centimeters and the total height of our building 40 centimeters. Sophie and I started off by making the frame of the building with straws. The building had to be at least 36 centimeters high, but we decided to make it 40 centimeters high. Once we finished the framework, we added cross braces for extra support. When we put the sandbags on, it will make it more sturdy. Then, we cut out the right size piece of paper to make a platform. This will allow the sandbags to rest on the building without falling through. Next, Sophie and I started to create a roof. We decorated the top and the sides with their names and polka dots for the top. After I finished making my building, I had to measure everything. Turns out, my measurements were different than what I had planned. Our total height of our building was 47 centimeters instead of 40 centimeters. I first wanted to make sure that my building could hold at least 4 sandbags before the actual test. This was a test to see how strong it was. Something that was really important to the building was the cross braces. These help support the building when there was a lot of pressure on it. They are attached in 8 places to have our building be strong. Sophie and I thought that one of the strongest places were where the frame of the building and the cross braces touch. They are held together by a few strands of tape that keeps them connected. In my opinion, I think that the weakest part of our building was the roof. That is because it's only a single, thin piece of paper, which won't hold much. Of course, we won't be able to put any sandbags on the top. The place where I put the most tape was where the frame and the cross braces meet. You want to make sure they are extremely supportive when it comes to weight. When we put the tape all around the straws, it will hold them together. We had 2 extra materials except for the straws and tape. The first extra material was paper, this which allowed the flooring. Next, we used markers to color and decorate our roof. When Mr. Clausette was shaking our building, we had 2 sandbags on the top and 2 sandbags on the bottom.
Mild earthquake.
It's not mild. That's pretty good.
Can you hold it?
Ooh.
Pretty good.
Well, I heard some
Our building held a total of 10 sandbags, 5 on the top and 5 on the bottom. The graph shows the movement of the tower in an earthquake. The x-axis stands for side-to-side motion, the y-axis shows front-to-back movement, and lastly, the x-axis shows up and down movement. Our building supported 10 sandbags, 5 on the top and 5 on the bottom. The part where our building failed was the centerpiece. It wasn't quite strong and it was placed diagonally. I would have liked to place the piece more vertically. Something that I learned was that you must have a strong building when it's under an earthquake. And something I really liked was that you can decorate your roof any way you want it. Our building supported 10 sandbags, 5 on the top and 5 on the bottom. Our building failed at the top because the supports weren't strong enough and they bent when they were on the earthquakes in there. I could have made the supports stronger, and I also could have made the cross ties stronger. I learned that the base of a building is very important. Building the roof and getting to see it on the earthquake simulator was really cool because I like to see how our tower turned out once we finished building it.